Right, in this video, it's all about The Drop. I'm using some tunes from the dance releases CD Pool November 2017. This one here is Boba K, track entitled Nothing Can Stop Us Now. So, it's about The Drop. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to wait till the end of the chorus and then drop in the next track. So, again, I don't want to tempt fate. What I'm going to do is move the track a little bit forward till we get to the chorus, and then I'll start it, because I don't want YouTube blocking this video. This is a demonstration. I'm trying to teach people. Come on, guys. Okay, so there we go. Alright, so pause that up there. Let's have a listen to track, second track I've got here, which is featuring Young Thug, Havana. Right, so okay, The Drop. This part of the track finished, which was, of course, the chorus, straight in to the next one. Now, these kinds of transitions are great for the main part of the night, because what you're doing, if you imagine, let's imagine, you know, these two tracks are taking us on a journey. We're at the bottom of the hill, we're going to the top of the hill, and then we're going to go to the other side of the hill. Now, if we were to have a journey where we're going up and down, up and down, up and down all the time, you're going to be taking people up, you're going to be lifting them, taking them back down again to the valley and back up and so on. What we don't want to do, that is what we don't want to do. In the main part of the evening, we want to try and keep them at that pinnacle, at the top, and by forming transitions like this, that's exactly what's happening. We're keeping them at the top of each hill, not taking them down to the bottom. Now, before I play any more of that track, I'm going to grab another one here, which is When They Go Low, Tough London Remix. Let's have a listen to this. Right, now, I'm thinking out loud here. I'm not going to edit this video. That is not going to fit in with the kind of, I suppose, structure of this lesson, because that's a little bit more deep. It's a little bit more underground. We want to keep the vibe up here. So let's have a listen to the next one, which is Close Encounters. Much better. All right. Okay, we've got a bit of a drop here. Do I want to start there? No, I'm just going to set a hot cue. Let's have a listen. Now again here, if I'm going to be very critical, the track, the actual vocals starts just before the count of one. Here, have a listen. Go back. The I in I've starts before the count of one. So one, two. Now, I reckon we can get away with that because it pretty much just sounds like being around. So I'm going to get that set there. Now again, we can beat match these if we want to. We can form a nice kind of smooth transition. But this sort of mixing technique, when you're just dropping it in, there's no real need. Now also, if you think about it, during the course of the evening, at the height of the evening, a lot of people want to listen to the centre part of the track where it's full on. Now, I'm not saying you don't really have time to form some kind of 8 or 16 bar mix. There's really no need, because all you have to do is think phrase, make sure that they are round about the same BPM, because you're chopping from one to the other and you haven't got a mix with the two overlapping, they do not have to be exactly in beat. But also, you've got to remember the musical content. You do not want to change the music too abruptly, otherwise you will lose the energy and the feel on the dance floor. So let's go back to our Young Thug Havana. And then wait till the end of the phrasing. Maybe wait till the end of the chorus. And then I'm going to bring in Roger Martin and Maurice. Okay. All right, let's do that again, because even though it worked, the Roger Martin seemed to be a little bit slow. It seemed to dip. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to increase the speed of Roger Martin. I'm on plus or minus 10%. So I'm going to bring it up about 8%. Right, so let's go back again to our Young Thug. Yeah, much better. Okay, again, same time I'm going to bring Roger Martin in. Three, four, one, two, three, four, one, five, four, three. Much better. So much better. Okay, so using this kind of mixing technique, you're going to keep the vibe, you're going to keep the energy, and also, again, you know, there's no need in beat matching, especially if you're going to be gelling two tracks together that are radio style versions. All right, now I hope this has been a help. Don't forget, I'm using the dance releases at the moment from CD Pool. There will be a link in the description. And even though a lot of people are saying, yeah, you do loads of promotion for CD Pool, well, yeah, I do. Also, I like their music. Also, their music is very good. But also what I do, I try and endeavour to always add some form of tutorial in with the videos as well. All right, hope that's been a help. Practice and enjoy. I do. Thank you very much.